And now I want to give you a live demo of one of the coolest features we have at the moment, which is called Nextcloud Text. So this is the Nextcloud interface as I described it. Right here on the top, you have your navigation of the different components. Here you can select on your different files that you shared with others or have your favorite and so on. And of course, here is the plus button that you can use to create a new file. Okay, so you can do different things, upload a file, create a folder, create like an office document, a spreadsheet, and so on. But what I'm doing here today is do this new text document. So I pick a name, call it test file. Okay, and what happens now is that I'm inside an editor, and this is a markdown editor, and I can do different things here. Where's the navigation bar? Okay, whatever. I can edit a document here, and I can, let me see, do bold text, or I can do a list here. So you can basically edit a rich document here, and this is a markdown document. I don't know how many of you know markdown, but it's very cool because it's actually a normal text file, but you can structure your text like that. And the cool thing is, of course, I can then close it, and it's just a normal text file. And this is then, of course, immediately synchronized to all my other devices, synchronized to my phone and my desktop, and I can open it with local markdown editors because there are lots of markdown editors out there for all platforms. Okay, but let's go back into it. So here's again my document. And what I can do now too is I can open this sidebar here and I can see what versions here exist. And I can see there's already different versions of the file. I can roll back if I made a mistake, or I can see some activities, what I did with the file, leave a comment and do other things. But what's really cool, what's very interesting is, of course, I can also share this file with others. Let's go to sharing here. And I want to share it with Julius, who is sitting here in the audience, and he is actually the main developer of this app. And if I click on this in this input line, you can see already some suggestions. So this is some machine learning features that we developed like lately, where we suggest like different users that you probably want to share this document with. Okay, let's type Julius, and here Julius here, click. And then we can see here in the list that he has now access to the file. And I can here, for example, say if it should be read-only or edit rights. But in this case, I give him edit rights. So he's also like here in the same document now. And now if I type, oh, you can already see Julius typing here. Okay. So this is actually collaborative editing of a markdown file in Nextcloud. So this is like a full markdown editor, which is works collaboratively. I can also type here, and he made something bold here at the top. So this is super, super useful. And again, I can close it and sync it to my phone later and sync it back and keep on working on it. So it's super, super flexible there. Okay, but of course, because Julius might be not in the same room, but somewhere else, we need to coordinate what we are doing here. And for that, you can click on the chat button here. And then I actually have a chat with the people who are editing the same document at the same time. Okay, here, Julius joined the conversation too. Say hi. So we can actually chat here and really work together on the same document. And this is not limited to two people. You can have as many people as you want working on the same document together. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Okay, but I mean, chatting is nice, but of course you might actually want to directly talk with the person. And now I have this start call button here that I can press. Let's see what happens now. Oh, now if you actually have a video call. Yeah, so this is this also works with more people. It's not limited to two people, but we can actually have a video call. I have switched off audio here, it would be a bit too confusing. But we have a real call with several people with a chat where you work collaboratively on a document. And this is super useful for like meeting notes or other things. And that's a very, very powerful feature. And again, it's not limited here to the web interface. You can also keep on working on Mac, Windows, Linux, iOS, Android. They're very nice Markdown editors too. Okay, cool, then thanks a lot. And let's go back to the slides.